Welcome back! My name is ballerscuba. This is Video Games Over Time! We are still in 1983. Today, we're going to talk about Tapper. The story of Tapper takes us to a company named Marvin Glass & Associates. Marvin Glass & Associates, abbreviated MGA, is an American toy design and engineering firm. Founded in 1941, MGA became most famous for their designs for popular toys such as Mousetrap, Rock'em Sock'em Robots, Light Bright, Ants in the Pants, and Simon. Bally Midway reached out to MGA in order to make arcade games in the 1980s. We have talked about Bally Midway before. Bally had officially merged with its subsidiary Midway in 1982. The newly merged company was responsible for Ms. Pac-Man and the Tron arcade game. We last talked about Bally Midway in our video on Spy Hunter. The partnership between Bally Midway and MGA would result in a few games, including Tapper. The programmers on the game were Steve Meyer and Elaine Ditton. The artist for the game was Scott Morrison. The composer for the game was Rick Hikaru. All of these games are new to us, unsurprisingly. Tapper is an action arcade game. In the game, the player plays as a bartender in a bar. There are four bars that the player has to manage, with customers coming in from one side and kegs on the other. The player's goal is to pour beer and slide it to the customers before they reach the end of the bar. After drinking, the customers may slide the empty mug back. The player must prevent all mugs from falling off the bar and breaking. Customers may also leave tips, which can be collected for extra points. When the player collects the tips, a small celebration takes place, which can momentarily distract the customers. If the player is able to serve all the customers, the bartender will pour himself a drink and a small funny scene will play. The player will then move on to the next level for a total of four different locations. Each location has its own music to go with it. Between each location, there is a bonus level. In the bonus level, six cans of beer are placed on the bar. Five of them are shaken, and then the cans are scrambled by a masked figure. If the player chooses the unshaken can, then the player will receive bonus points. Otherwise, the can will spray the bartender in the face. Because the original game was sponsored by Anheuser-Busch, an American beer company, a prominent Budweiser logo is in the back of the bar. The game was originally designed to be distributed in bars. The arcade cabinet came with a tap that moves the bartender back to the keg. Early versions of the game had an actual Budweiser beer tap attached to the cabinet. Later versions of the game had a plastic replica of the tap. Bally Midway released Tapper to American arcades on September 2nd, 1983. The game would be released in European arcades in late 1983. Sega would release the game to Japanese arcades in March 1984. That is the short backstory to Tapper. With that now told, it's time to play the game for ourselves. Here we are in the game. This is Tapper. This is the original 1983 version, copyright Bally Midway. You pull the tapper to fill the mug. As you can see, there's little Budweiser beer logos basically on everything here. Yes, you basically pull the tap to fill it, let go to fling it, then you can run around. You have to catch the empty mugs. You can get the tips. I'm not going to get too many of the tips, I don't think, because it causes issues for me. But yeah, then you get an extra man at 20,000 points. We'll see if I can do that. As it plays Oh Susanna in the background. Very catchy, copyright-free song from olden times, and then you lose, and that's it. Yeah, I put in a high score. I can beat that, I hope. Just trying to make sure everything was working properly, and I got a high score because there's nothing on the game so far. But basically, that is the game. It's fairly straightforward. The only thing is that, obviously, I don't have a tap. I don't have that kind of setup, so I have a button instead, but other than that, it'll pretty much be the same experience for me. So let's go ahead and put a quarter in, and let's go. Yeah, the customers are different. It looks like there was like a duck there. They give you different points. Now, if you can't beat level one. There you go. Go away. Level one is easy, and then I'll pour myself a drink, and then, hey, nicely done. Shattered a glass, wasted money. Yeah, chances are I'm not going to get all of them to go back each time. Yeah, there's money, but it's not worth the effort to go get it. It is way down there. I will get other money. But yeah, you can see the big Budweiser logo. Big beer company in America, if you're unfamiliar with it. Possibly the largest, especially at the time. There you go, Budweiser. Watch closely. All right, he's shaking up the cans. All right, so it's the third from the right. Let's follow it. All right, it is still third from the right. This Bud's for you, which is the advertising slogan of Budweiser. All right, now we're outside and things have changed a bit. Yeah, you want to stick with the one up top if you can. No, oh, did I get him? I'm not sure I'm gonna be able to get all these guys. All right, down again. One, two, three. Man, they are rowdy. How many beers do you guys need? Got there just in time. No! I flung one too many, and there it goes. You gotta be careful. You can't fling too many over. Otherwise, it will crash and you will fail. Ah, I can't get back up there in time. Yeah, this second level really gets to me. You left me a tip, but I am not gonna get that one. Oh yeah, I gotta catch these. I'm gonna go for it. All right, so there's the little celebration. It distracts some of the customers. It doesn't get all of them. That's okay. Nope, they got to the end, and this is what happens when you fail there. And that's the game. I got 14,000. We'll put in my initials this time. How do we do that? Up? Okay. Up and down, it looks like. Yeah, there's probably not too much chance for me to do much better than that, but I think I'm gonna give it one more shot here. There we go, my actual initials. Okay, we'll put in one more quarter and try again. And this is a fairly hard game for people that are supposed to be drunk, right? And you get 1,500 points for collecting the money, so. You know, a lot of people swear by getting the money, but it is difficult. It will warp you back if you hit the tapper button again. If you hit the tap, it'll warp you all the way back. And going up and down will help as well. Maybe I'll try to get a little bit more. Okay, you guys are gonna stick around? All right, let's get that. The first level, if you're failing there, I'm not sure how to help you, to be honest. Second level, I could see you failing a bit, but the first level, it's like, sometimes you can get through it right away. All right, level two down. Oh no, my foot! If I don't shatter the glass, it hurts so much more. All right, third from the left. Still third from the left. Maybe I should get drunk to make this harder for me, but that one's fine. Okay, this one. No! Oh, I can actually warp all the way there? I didn't know that. Yeah, if the people are distracted, they will not catch a beer, which is why it sometimes causes problems for me. Are you guys serious? You're still back for more? Like, the game's not over, guys. I'm gonna go for it. Okay, we got there in time. No! I knew it as soon as I threw it. Yeah, I don't know how the bartender is able to warp so quickly, but that is a thing that he can do. Okay, let's go back up there. Yeah, he's a warping bartender, and I'm being quiet because I'm trying to concentrate. Like, I have a chance here to actually make it through. Okay, let's get that. No! Oh, somebody else showed up, thankfully. And then two here. There's a third one there. Okay, throw that, two there. This is a long level, especially compared to like the first level. Now knowing that I can warp, no, couldn't get there in time. Knowing that I can warp from the bottom to the top and from the top to the bottom really does make things a little bit easier for me. I don't know why I didn't try that before. Okay. Like, how are we not through the level? But then again, we weren't through it last time. Like, that should be more than enough beer for these people. Just because there's people playing sports doesn't mean you need to get drunk. Just one there. Yeah, the... The tips actually do help a lot on this level. They don't early on, but later on. Why do I need so much? Once again, how are we not through this level? We should be through this. Just go away. Take your beer and go away. No, I'm not. Yeah, I can't get both of them. I couldn't get both. I got a free life, so we're gonna go again. But yeah, this is the best that I'm gonna be able to do. I can't make it through this stage. Yeah, warping out of there. Super helpful. Without it, I'm not sure that this game could be anywhere close to fair. Alright, I need that, and I'll grab these. Alright, one there, two there, two more. We're going! I'm getting a little bit better at some of my strategies, but not a lot of them. We'll grab those. Didn't fully fill that beer, so it doesn't count. Some of these guys show up way too early in the bar. Like, some of them are showing up like a third of the way through. Where'd you come from? Up! He didn't do it as quickly as I would like. Alright, the basketball guy moves fast. Yeah, I can't get all of them back. Alright, so that's the game. Overwhelmed by the friggin' sports rush. Just because people are hitting each other hard. I don't know. It looks like a football stadium to me. American football stadium. So, like, my assumption is that they were smacking each other. You have the cheerleaders and all that. It's basically either football or basketball, but I was going to go with basketball. All right, so I did way better than I thought I was going to be able to, but that is the game played. And with the game played, it's time to talk about how it holds up today. Playing the game today, the first question I always ask is the game fun? And with Tapper, the answer is definitely yes. You might have heard me get quiet a little bit more than I normally do while I was playing the game. That's because I was concentrating, and I think that the gameplay holds up really well to the point that it really does make you want to kind of concentrate on the game and just ignore everything else around you, which may or may not work in a bar. The concept of the game being in a bar kind of changes the dynamic of the game a little bit, but overall, the game definitely is fun, and the gameplay is the main reason for that. The fact that you're just kind of pushing characters back and trying to keep them satisfied with beer, and, you know, the fact that I wasn't able to get through that third level, I believe it was the third level, because I wasn't able to get the beer to him fast enough. Kind of proves that the game does ramp up in difficulty, and it does really quickly, especially considering what the first level is like. To only make it to the third level and then start struggling to get through it kind of shows that the difficulty goes up quite a bit. But with that said, it was still fun the whole time I was doing it. Did I want the level to end so I could get a break? Sure, but that would probably come faster if I had more skill in the game. Speaking of skill in the game, I did look up the world record for this game. It is by a William Rosa, who scored 14,826,200 points. Now, obviously, I will never get to that point. I am not nearly good enough in the game. For me, the controls were a little stiff as well, but that might just be because of the way that I'm playing it. Finding an arcade cabinet of this game is something that I've actually never seen, so they do seem a little rare, so I just basically had a button instead of a tap, and maybe that would change some things. But playing the game, it's fun. You know, like I said, it has an addictive gameplay to it. It makes you want to come back for more often, and that's always a good sign. In terms of the graphics, I think the graphics are actually pretty damn good for 1983. I would say that they hold up pretty well. Everything looks like it's supposed to. The sound maybe could be a little bit better. I think the sound effects are good, but the music between Oh Susanna and a couple other copyright-free music that they play along the way could be improved, but overall I think that the game does have good sound, and I think it holds up well. It's not like it's a deterrent from people playing the game that the sound is bad or anything like that. But graphics and sound are good. The technical qualities are there. For a first game that we have seen from a new company, this is a strong showing, and I think that the game holds up well, and if you are interested in old arcade games, or you are interested in more of an action-oriented old-school game, this is a game that really should get your attention, and something that you should play. Tapper is something that holds up well, and that's my modern take on the game. When the game was released, it proved to be successful. Because of the nature of the game, it did not take long for an altered version of the game to be released. This version, named Root Beer Tapper, replaced the alcoholic version of the game and was designed primarily for arcades. This avoided the issue of looking like the game was advertising alcohol to children. The game would see several ports and re-releases over the years. We will keep an eye on these as we continue. With another success on their hands, Bally Midway would continue to be a big name in the American video game industry. We will hear from them again. As for MGA, although they would create a couple more games for Bally Midway, none would reach the success of Tapper, and we will not hear from them again. However, we will be hearing from Steve Meyer and Scott Morrison again, as they would continue to work in the video game industry. That will do it for the story of Tapper for now. My name is ballerscuba. This has been Video Games Over Time. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in our next video when we go for the gold.